Those strange visual auras that people get from migraines can actually be pretty scary, especially the first time that you experience it. It might make you feel like you're losing a portion of your vision, or you might see these weird light geometric patterns, kind of like you're looking through a kaleidoscope. So in this video, we're going to talk about everything you need to know about visual auras and migraines. So let's focus in. Hey, howdy everybody, this is Dr. Neil Guymon, Dr. EyeGuy, with a show that keeps your eyes healthy and your vision clear, and I do a lot of educational eye videos like this one, so consider subscribing for my future videos. Now let's talk about migraines with auras. Now let's first talk about the actual symptoms of this visual aura, and what's tricky here is a lot of people experience or see different visual auras. It totally depends on the person of what visual aura that they're seeing. Now the example I have playing on the video right now is just one example of many, but usually it will start off in the center of your vision as a blurry spot or a smudge, and it will grow and sometimes morph into a C pattern or a crescent shape. And eventually that shape will disappear, or it will grow and move off to the side of your vision and disappear there. And you might notice that spot in your vision might flicker, or sometimes that pattern will have these zigzag lines, might be colorful, it might be a black and white, might have two different patterns. It totally depends on the person. And that central blurry spot can actually block out your vision. You'll try and look at something or look at something small like a number, or you're trying to read, and it feels like you have to kind of look off to the side to read it because you have to get that blurry spot out of the way. So it makes it tricky to actually see what you're looking at for a little while. Now, typically these patterns will last about 15 to 30 minutes, again, depending on the person. Sometimes it can last upwards to 60 minutes. I've even had people say that they've lasted 2-3 hours, sometimes more, but the average time is 15 to 30 minutes. And then some people might get a headache right after this visual aura. Some people don't. I've had it both ways, where I've had a pretty bad headache after the visual aura. I've also had times where I had the visual aura, was expecting a headache, and never got one. And usually the people that don't get a headache after this visual aura will note that they just feel off, they just feel different. And that's actually exactly what happened to me, is I kind of felt different. I felt like maybe I had a dull ache, but I felt like my sensitivity was just turned up a few notches. I could feel my shirt more. It felt like I was about to get goosebumps all of the time, but never got goosebumps. So it just felt different. That's the best way I could describe it. And then there are some people that get headaches so bad that the only thing that they can do is just go in to their room, turn the lights off, make sure it's quiet, and just sleep it off. Now, usually migraines are more common in women than in men, and people that experience migraines, about 15 to 20% of them experience a visual aura. Hey, make sure that you check out the description below. I'll provide a link to a Google search of ocular migraines or visual auras, where people have tried to animate or put a picture or a drawing of what their visual aura looks like. And I'm kind of curious to see if you notice if one of those pictures might resemble what your aura looks like as well. The next question everybody wants to know is, why do they have this weird aura in their vision? And unfortunately, there's no definitive answer yet. It's still somewhat of a mystery in the eye world, but there are a few leading theories and a few findings that correlate to what's happening in your brain when you have a visual aura. Now, the visual aura is actually taking place in your brain, not in your eyeballs. Your brain is what's causing this visual aura. The leading idea to the cause of this visual aura is something called cortical spreading depression, or CSD. The idea with CSD is that it'll cause certain brain cells, usually in the back of your brain, the visual cortex, to depolarize. Brain cells have a polarization, kind of like the Earth has a north and south pole. These brain cells will depolarize and actually cause a ripple effect, kind of like if you were to drop a rock into a pond and cause these ripples will spread out across your brain. Then they also found correlation within these ripples of blood flow. Within the ripples, they'll have increased blood flow to that section of the brain, and then once the ripples move farther, they'll have decreased blood flow in that same section after the ripples are gone. So between the depolarization of CSD and the blood flow issues, it can cause the nerves in your brain to act weird and make you think that you're seeing light or blurry vision or certain weird things in your vision, which causes that visual aura. And it kind of makes sense to me as where most visual auras will kind of start off in the center of your vision, starting off at a certain point in your brain, and it'll eventually kind of grow bigger and sometimes grow to your peripheral vision and disappear. And that's exactly what happened with my most recent one. Started in the center, kept a full circle, and that full circle just got bigger and bigger and bigger until it disappeared from the side of my vision. Even with this cortical spreading depression and this blood flow, there's still theories. There still isn't a definitive answer to the cause of a visual aura or the cause of this depolarization or the blood flow. There's no actual answer why that happens in the brain. Now, most of the time people notice that this visual aura is actually happening in both eyes because it's actually happening in the back of the brain. Now, there are some visual auras that you can get on just one eye called an ocular migraine, and you can kind of tell if you kind of cover your eyes back and forth and see if you can see where that visual aura is. The more common one is actually happening in the back of your brain with both eyes. Now, that being said, the next thing that people want to know is, okay, what's going to trigger my migraine? What's going to trigger a visual aura with my migraines? The actual list of triggers that can cause a migraine with a visual aura is pretty exhaustive. There's a huge list. Genetics is one thing to consider. If you have a family history of people that get migraines, you might be more prone to get migraines as well. There are also environmental factors, lights, strong smells like perfumes. There are also some foods that can trigger migraines, kind of like cheeses, chocolate, some certain meats, caffeine, also additives that they can put in the food like MSG or artificial sweeteners. Also, there are certain things like lack of sleep, anxiety, and stress. All of those can actually be your trigger for migraines. Sometimes hormone changes related to age can also trigger migraines as well. And one thing that tipped me off for mine is after I'd eat Chinese food, I'd usually get a migraine, sometimes a visual aura as well. And I'm pretty sure it's the MSG that's in the Chinese food. And so sometimes I just have to stay away from that to avoid the trigger of my migraine. So the next question is, what can you do about the migraine or about the visual aura? What is the treatment? First off, if this is the first time that you're experiencing a visual aura, better to be safe than sorry. Get your eyes checked out. There are a few different ocular conditions that can cause similar symptoms, kind of like floaters in your eyes can cause these weird things in your vision that aren't necessarily a visual aura, but might be a sign of something going wrong with your eye. And if you're ever experiencing any type of vision loss or weird stuff in your vision, it's just better to have it checked out to rule out any other eye conditions there are. A lot of times migraines and visual auras is a diagnosis of exclusion, meaning you're getting rid of all these other possibilities or other possible eye conditions, and then you're left with a visual aura from a migraine. I'll get people in the clinic all of the time. It's their first time experiencing this weird visual aura. They're scared that they lost their vision. They'll come in, and usually by the time that they come into the clinic, the symptoms are gone, but they feel weird. And we'll usually look at the eyeballs, do a dilation, look at the periphery of the eyes, and it'll be fine. And usually that means that it's actually a visual aura with a migraine that's happening in the brain. Now, I actually had a migraine with a visual aura happen to me while I was working and seeing patients. And right in between patients, I took pictures of my eyes just to see if there's anything weird with the actual structure of my retina or my blood vessels to see if there's anything different. And my eyes were actually fine, looked perfectly normal compared to my previous pictures. So I couldn't see anything weird. So it was obviously happening in my brain. If you can figure out the trigger to your migraine, you want to try and avoid that trigger if you can. Like I just showed you in this video, I just ate Chinese food, so I'm hoping I don't get a migraine. Now, a lot of times when people get this visual aura, it's a precursor or a sign that a headache is coming. Sometimes you'll get the aura first, and then 15 or 30 minutes later, you'll get the headache. And so when people see this visual aura, it tells them, hey, it's time to take some medication, either Excedrin or ibuprofen, to get control of the headache quicker and faster before it really hits them hard. Now, if you're experiencing the migraine with visual aura more frequently, or maybe the headache is actually getting worse, you definitely want to go into your primary care provider or your neurologist so they can actually do a deep dive, more detective work of what might be causing this migraine, because there are more serious conditions like tumors or masses in your brain, you know, some things that might be scarier that you need to make sure that you don't have. There are also certain medications that are prescribed that can help with migraines, like Topamax, for one example. This is where you'll talk with your primary care provider or your neurologist of figuring out the best treatment for your migraines. And like I mentioned before, sometimes the headaches are so bad that the treatment is just to go into a quiet room, lights off, no noise, go to sleep and sleep it off. I'm actually curious to hear from you on this one. Leave a comment below if you've experienced migraines with visual auras. I'm curious to hear what your visual aura looks like. The range is all across the board. I've heard some people where almost a whole center part of their vision is blacked or grayed out. I've heard that their whole vision is blurry, a section of their vision is blurry, so I'm kind of curious to see what you experience. Hey, thanks for watching that whole video. Make sure you hit that like button. I'm Dr. Neil Guymon, Dr. Eye Guy, focusing on you and your eyes. Stay focused, check out my other videos right there, and I'll see you in the next video.